छोटे बैलून का।
बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द लेक्चर ऑफ हाइपोपिट्यूटरीज़म। बिफोर आई रियली गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय प्रेजेंटेशन, फर्स्ट आई इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ एंड माय ग्रुपमेट। दिस इज वजाहत एंड दिस इज फरहान। बिफोर आई रियली गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय प्रेजेंटेशन, आई वांट टू टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट द बेसिक कंटेंट्स ऑफ द हाइपोपिट्यूटरीज़म। First we talk about the definition of the hypopituitarism, then we talk about the causes, then we cause the clinical feature, and then we talk about the investigation of, and at the end we talk about the management. Before I really going to start my presentation, first of all I want to tell you I follow the same method that Sir Ali followed when he going to teach us some new system in our body. First he tell us the normal anatomy, now my physiology, and then he talk about the little bit of pathology. I same follow the method of Dr. Ali. Okay, first we talk about the in this hypopituitarism, you must know about the something about the hypothalamus, and then you must know about which hormones releases from the anterior pituitary and the posterior pituitary, and what they are doing, what their main function, and what if they are because this is really important. Because of that, if some kind of tumor, some kind of adenoma occur in the anterior pituitary and go to the upside, and also involve the hypothalamus, then what kind of complication occur? So in this way, you must have to know about something about the knowledge of hypothalamus also, and the pituitary also, and the surrounding structure also. I give you first 20 minutes briefly about the physiology and anatomy and a little bit of pathology. Then we will only take 5 minutes for the slide. First, I will make your basic concept. Then I will go to the PPT. That's okay. Oh. Okay. First, you must have to know about something about the hypothalamus. What is the hypothalamus and what is main function? Can anybody tell me the hypothalamus main functions? There are 3 main functions. Hypothalamus concerned with your limbic system. Limbic system that is concerned your emotion, your recent memories. And your emotions. Second thing, the hypothalamus also concerned with the endocrine system. Endocrine system, the third main system, the hypothalamus also concerned with your autonomic nervous system, the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. These are the main 3 functions of the hypothalamus. If something happens in the anterior pituitary or posterior pituitary that goes upward and also involves the hypothalamus, then what kind of complication occurs, we discuss here, inshallah. So after that, you know about the where is the hypothalamic exactly present. I will tell you in my diagram. If you look at this one, this is the midbrain, this is the pons, medulla, this is cerebellum. Exactly in this position, there is a hypothalamus is located. Here is the hypothalamus have 2 cells. One is the we call mammary bodies at this one. So second swelling is the median aminus, and that is where the pituitary stalk and pituitary stalk that made it two and pituitary system, anterior pituitary and posterior pituitary. This is the normal thing. And what are the surrounding structures that represent in the hypothalamus? Hypothalamus present in the, if you look at the hypothalamus, this is the lateral view. You look at the side, okay? So, but if you look at the side, here is the midbrain present. Here at the third, here is a lateral wall of third ventricle. Ventricle system, you know, 2 ventricles, lateral ventricles, 1 third ventricle, and 1 is a fourth ventricle. That is concerned your CSF production. So if you know that, so here is the main other thing that is that is related to this the optic chiasma. That is also present at the surrounding of the hypothalamus. So if something happens in the anterior pituitary and it go upward to the hypothalamus and it also involves this structure, so what kind of complication we have to see now? Okay? Understand? Okay. First, I want to tell you what is hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is a sheet of gray matter in which so many nuclei present. I will tell you one by one these nuclei and its functions and how they release into the different kind of hormones. I will also tell you. The gentleman that made these diagrams, here, that The diagram show that there are different kind of nuclei present in the pituitary. The first is the preoptic nucleus. Preoptic nucleus, in the preoptic nucleus, gonadotropic releasing hormone release from gonadotropic releasing hormone factor release from the that nucleus that come to down to into the anterior pituitary. Anterior pituitary cells present that release to the gonadotropic release hormone that go to the general circulation.